Learning is important in life, and unless you learn, you are nowhere. But after some time, you should know where to draw up a line. And after that, time comes, you have to give back to society. The kind of solace and satisfaction one gets is phenomenal, and it cannot be compared with anything.
Welcome, sir, to my first interview. It's my first interview with you, so I welcome you very much. So my question is that, what was beginning? How you started?
See, when we came to Pune in 2013, we were very few in the society, and I found that most of the area was a barren, and it was appearing to be some very deserted kind of thing. And we grew some plant inside our society, but outside land was extremely barren kind of thing. And my fear was that if it remains like that, some unscrupulous elements will come and start dwelling. So that was the main drive behind whatever I did in so many years.
So who motivated you? How was the first few days?
No, I had been throughout my life in making the pharmaceutical plants throughout India, and I was quite aware of how the plants are to be grown and where they can grow, and we thought difficult terrain, what they could be done. So that's what a sort of at the back of my mind, and I was very confident that if you work on the plant and give them proper water and manure and all these things, you can grow anything anywhere.
And how many plants are there now? And first, how you started your work?
I first started without anybody's help, because I initially started to sell my idea with some people, but as usual, typically in Pune, people try to discourage me in the fact that they saying that nothing will grow, this is a barren piece of land, not even grass grows. So you're wasting your energy, talents, and more than that, your own money. And one good thing I did, that I did not involve my society. Even though I am the secretary of the society for last 10 years, but I didn't involve the society for any reason, for the fact that I never wanted to involve many people who put me more questions than helping.
Yes. But how were the first few days?
First few days were very interesting. I could get a lot of plants as a donation, and also I bought. My wife also joined me in coming with me to nearby nursery, and whatever we could afford, we could buy. And with the help of my local gardener, and at our own cost, I did this work for at least 3 years. It costs me a very huge amount, but that was my hobby. So I thought, okay, let me do it. About first 4 years, I did all alone, maybe around 1500 trees. I had put all alone by through donation or through buying or through whatever means. To some people used to donate me some trees if they had excess in their house. But last 3 years, many people started, and last 2 years have been phenomenally different. Many people joined me, and they really helped a lot. One of my colleagues, he was equally interested like me. Saushal Gupta is his name. Once again, like me, he's in the pharma company, he's a finance person. And his daughter was also interested. And there are a couple of more who came. We used to go to a nearby nursery in Thewur and all other places, bring all those plants in our own plant, our cars.
Yes.
So that whatever money we could save on transportation, that we were putting. And last 2 years, we have put another huge number of trees, taking the total to 3,000 trees. We have put in between also the pipeline, water pipeline, that is the, our society has a very efficiently running sewage treatment plant. The wastewater we first come, that we diverted. That's the only thing which I took from my society without paying for it. I don't pay for the water, but the pipeline was put at our cost. And we drew the pipeline on both sides of the land where we use. It's close to about 40,000 square feet, approximately an acre of land which we use. And kind of trees we have developed, it's a concept which is called Miyawaki concept. Tell me very frankly, we knew about Miyawaki concept after we developed it, not before developing. This is a Japanese botanist who developed this technique of creating a jungle in a less place. It's a length of about 3 feet by 3 feet, about 10 square feet of we can grow tree. So we have first done it, and now I realize it is Miyawaki. So I, just to create interest with the people, I call it a Miyawaki jungle. In jungle, you don't get the same trees, you get different trees. So that's why we drew that concept, and we try to put all different number of plants. I mean, there are no duplication. There are a lot of plants like...
Which are the major plants?
Major plants which are called badam trees, then the wood apple, then neem, ashoka, then a lot of trees which are indigenously sourced and also which are consistent ecologically in this area. And we, of course, we have certain bougainvillea and some creepers. We even try to put a little bit bamboo also. Then we have some flowers like jasmine. Then we have, that's a hibiscus, what it's called. And then we have trees like ratrani. Then we have woodland. All different kinds of things.
So my question is, in few days, first few days, some trees were not growing. Is how you thought that?
No. All the trees were growing because I'm being a diabetic, I walk almost 11 kilometers a day, and it's my proud hobby to see the health of my each and every tree, and I make sure that not a single tree is dried up. At times we have taken efforts to water this plant, and I put my personal efforts whenever I am in town, and then I make sure that every day my trees are looked after.
So how much time you give?
See, every day almost about 1 hour is minimum, and Saturday, Sunday I spend more time. In rainy season, probably at occasions I spend even half a day. Summer, especially for trimming, cleaning, etc., we have spent much more time. But I never count time. I mean, whatever occurs to my mind, whenever I am bored, I just go. I tell my wife, I'm going to my farm, and I wear my shoes, gloves, goggles, hat, and my all my tools are with me, cutter, secateur, small hacks, all kinds of things.
So my next question is, what was the challenges after growing?
That I had more challenges, not natural challenges, were unnatural challenges, like antisocial element, people in the adjoining area, they couldn't see. Unfortunate part is that they cannot see cat beauty.
Yes.
People come there and put all kinds of drinks, wine bottle, drink bottle, beer bottle, cigarette butts. People come and spoil that thing. In night, people come and there is a lot of antisocial elements.
How
you
would tackle that problem?
Yeah, that also I try to, whenever it happens in my life, irrespective of whatever this thing, I stand there, ask them to get out. I really take the help of
them.
No. Once or twice I picked up huge coral with people, and to my help, lot of people come from outside. They came. Lot of young people from outside also, they can help. They came. But only thing is that when I'm not there, say for the night and all, what happened? There is absolutely no help from police or any other. There has been no help from any corporation or any sort of. But we are not worried about that. I always believe. And if you want to do something, don't give reasons and creak about this is not there, that is not there. If you want to do something, you can. Water. See, for example, our society doesn't have municipal water. And I have grown 3,000 trees. Where did the water come from? So, okay. You have to be that attitude of Raja Bhagirath to bring Ganges from sky. So that attitude, if you have got, you can do anything with it.
Which innovations you did for this idea? Innovations.
The innovation was nothing. The innovation was only thing was that we never saw which tree I am growing. Whatever was available, whatever we could afford. I forgot the name of the tree, which is coming from Pythas family. And that tree is a heat absorbing tree. I forgot the name of that tree. But if we have put a very expensive sapling, it's about 3,300 rupees per sapling. I put 20 of them and all are alive. And those trees are from the botanically, they are available from the Pythas family, and I forgot the name of that tree, but then they are growing.
Yes,
and this year, I would like to put some trees like Rakta Chandan and some trees of Kadamba, so that they are also heat absorbent. So let me see all these things.
In growing days, how people saw
it? Now people are appreciating. At least the people who are living in our society, they are quite appreciative. Some of them, very few contribute. Very few people say, oh, this is very good, very good. But when it comes to a little bit of contribution, nothing comes out. But there are, I'm not worried
about
that.
How do you manage that things?
Fortunately, I could spend a lot of my money and then
saying it will not grow.
No, that's right, because I said that even if it doesn't grow, it's my money, why are you bothered about it? So I said you are not to worry about it because it's my money. Initially I spent quite a dear amount of this.
Can you please tell about
it? It's in the several thousand. So this year we spent close to about 1.5 lakh rupees from contribution and all, but prior to that all this fund I was doing it. But that's my hobby, and one has to spend for the hobby. So people have a lot of habits. I have this hobby. I said, okay, let me do this kind of. But now, at least I'm very happy that people are appreciative of the effort. Not all are contributing, but many are now coming forward, and especially the young children. What happened? We really put this to young kids in the schools and all. I really try to put this idea in their mind. So I go and approach parents that if you want to celebrate the birthday of your son or daughter, why don't you sponsor some 20 plants? There was one lady who said my son turned 21. So she gave 21 into 20 rupees, about some 400 and odd rupees, to plant 21 trees in the name of her son. That's a wonderful idea. So like that, we motivate people
and
to do
how
like
you
that.
How you manage your work and this?
See, I'm a retired buff, so there's no question of any. But yeah,
I'm doing many stuff.
In a consultancy and I have a lot of my other. But that's only. This is just a sort of, if you try to do something systematically, time always comes out.
And people tell that time is not there.
No. It's all bakwas according to me. If you want to do something, time is always. Time is absolutely no issue, provided you manage it properly and do it. I have never found that my trees are suffering for my want of my time. They never happen. When I told you, when I travel outside, when I come in, my first job is to go and see my plants are there, how often they have been watered. You know, our garden contractor.
Do you feel lazy going day by day 3 years, seeing that plants on the. Do you feel lazy to do that
only once? No. I feel enthusiastic rather. My plants are my friends.
Yes.
They speak to me. I talk to them. I really grow with them. It's a meditation for me. In the morning when I go out, I mean, I see that whizzing sound from this thing. We see a lot of birds are coming.
Yes.
Because the plants are growing, birds are coming. The
and
birds,
you feel
they come,
energetic very much.
Yes. Birds come. They eat away all the ants and all. Look
yes.
at that, the natural cycle.
Yes.
Birds come, they eat away a lot of ants. So that is ecologically taken care of. Birds, they eat, you know, a lot of quail in the morning
yes,
and all.
Yes.
Beautiful. If you listen to the quail, so it is so heartening. It is so beautiful.
And this is the energy of your
yes,
body.
And especially in the morning, you see a lot of flowers. And I always see sometimes in the morning people come and pluck flowers.
Yes.
We have to fight with it. They say, no, we are wanting to pluck and offer this to God. I said, no, some God, what is that? Why are you wanting to disturb by this thing? So every time.
Do you feel greedy? Means some flowers are dead and you want to pick up.
No, I never. We don't pick up a single flower. No.
What is the reason behind it?
No. They should. They are nature's property. They should say people should enjoy seeing the flower and the plant, not on something. I said if you want to offer to God.
Somewhere I read that picking flower. It is good for them. They will grow. Is it?
No. Flowers is okay, the natural thing. It's okay. There are a lot of flowers available in the market. You go and buy one for some 120 rupees. Go and offer it to God. Why you want to disturb my garden?
And one more question is that how this incident transformed you?
It has transformed me. First is a wonderful utilization of time. Second thing is that at my age now, probably when you grow up, you tend to lose some of your friends.
Yes.
So, and you don't get the same friends at
yes.
this age.
Yes.
What are my friends at my childhood, at my career, at my what is it? So the ones they are. For some reason, maybe you change cities and all these things, so you don't get, but they want to have to substitute it.
Yes.
So you substitute by this kind of natural hobbies.
Correct.
And that hobby has become now my habit. So it's something like that.
So what you will tell for youth generation, how you will motivate them to do this?
I would always want new generation to at least look after the nature and contribute. Nature by planting more trees, because that is the need of that hour.
No, but yes, in planting in our society they will plant but they will not look over.
That is what, it's not only planting and taking selfie and posting it on Facebook. That's why I said that. You make it sure, I tell boys, and I always tell people that you plant a tree in the name of your son. So you will never see your son dying, can you?
No.
So you say, no, this is my son's plant. So I will make sure that it is one plant, my granddaughter planted a tree. Every day I go and see, because sometimes my granddaughter asks me, Dadu, send me the picture of my plant. So I'm so careful about that tree. Remember, that is planted by my granddaughter. So it's my, okay, it's my personal. I think that kind of personal pride in maintaining
those. Yes, and when you were planting this, in mind something came, it is a foolishness, why you are doing that? Like these thoughts came
on? No, it never came to mind. Because planting plants and trees, I never thought it's a foolishness. I thought it's an act of God. If God has sent you to do this kind of thing, and this is required for the nature, you are serving Mother Nature, right? It is required, it's a tomorrow's need. What is required is a tree. We are more interested in cutting trees. But here we would like to plant trees.
Yes, correct. So how you will advise to grow plant? How you grow in first plant?
I will advise any young generation of mature, whenever you find some space.
No, which space?
Very mature place. You don't worry about it. Wherever you find a vacant space, plant trees. If you need to remove them for some time, we can find out the reason. But don't wait, no, this will go under a road demolition, this will go under some new development. We'll watch it little later. Some people warn me, no, a road will come and then yahan se road jayega, fir a tree. I said, jab jayega, tab nikal denge. Ab tab to chalne do na.
Yes.
Ab tak kyun karenge?
Haan, tab tak wo aayega.
Aayega, tab aayega, tab dekhe.
Or suppose it is any tar road or cement road, what you will advise? But
tar road and cement road, you can't do anything about it. But there's no dearth of space in this thing.
Yes. Tremendous soil and plant.
Yeah. Only you have to dig a pit, put some black soil, put a little bit of compost, as we come compost by here, which is there, generated by all the society. Make sure that first 2 to 3 or 4 years you water them properly. See, rainy season takes care.
Yes.
Almost for 1/3 of the year, we are not looking. After the 2-3 years which is there, you have to see you water them. Don't put the plant if you are not able to water. So if you can water the plant. That's why I said that you plant the plants within your reach. Don't go and plant somewhere in the jungle where you can't do anything. You're doing so, for example, I have done within 1-2 kilometer periphery.
Yes. So do you know some plants which will easily grow and motivate them to plant
more? Lot many plants grow, but we have to see what is ecologically consistent in that area, and that you have to grow those plants. Okay? The one which is very, very fast growing and all, it is not a criteria. Criteria is what is ecologically consistent.
Very great job by you. I thank you. It motivated me to come from Solapur to Pune. So I thank you very much.
Thank you.
This thing, I never expected this will grow like this.
Yes.
But look at it.
So it is very beautiful. Wow. So this is grown by Shyam sir. Very nice it is.
And we have done pipelines throughout this.
Yes.
So that this SAP water, this is, look at that now, you are asking me about this flower.
Yes.
Look at the tree which has this. Is look at this tree. Yes.
Our mentality is that to pluck the flowers. So
the flowers here.
Yes. They are very happy. So how many acres it is, Pulal?
This is about 40,000 square feet.
40,000
about an acre.
Yes. So it is very. The first, which was the first plant?
I don't recollect. Whatever came to my mind.
Which area?
Yeah, this one.
We started from here. Where all fencing.
That I told you, no? That don't shoot, that's it, but the beer bottle and all, the people should plug.
Oh.
So this is what is the trouble is not from nature, trouble is from the people. Around.
Nature always supports.
Nature is very supportive, very kind. I must say God has been very, very kind with respect to rainwater and all this. It is only the people who are...
So we appeal from this video, please do not do that. It is a humble request.
I had put a lot of... signboards and all, even people have removed that because they're all destructive people.
Yes.
Look at that, now they come and dump this kind of thing.
Yes.
We clean this area, but they dump all this kind of thing. Now we have put some bamboos also over there.
Yes.
Look at that, with the bamboos and all. So we would like to create little bunch.
Yes.
So,
That side also you only did?
Yeah, this side.
Both sides.
Both sides.
It is very thick now. These all are your children's. These all are your kids.
Yeah. They are not my kids. I am their kids. This look at that. We have put sign. All those signs and
yes,
all.
Yes, yes.
I downloaded from internet. Got it laminated at my home. Put them
yes,
like
yes.
that. People bring dogs. What can you do? Look at that. All these people bring dogs.
Yes.
They will never clean the dirt. I mean the minage done by the dog.
Yes.
They take pride in doing this thing. But what can we do?
Yes.
Look at
yes.
that. All this all green. This
correct. Food. Wow. And very beautiful. So what is your next step?
The next step is just as I told you. This. Rainy season, we would like to put another 2,000 trees.
2,000.
To make trees with plants and all. Into
yes.
It. So, one side they make
so while investing, do you feel anything means I should not invest that much amount of money?
No.
It's not for me.
No. I never think that way. Lot of trees I enjoyed, they were not planted by
these
me.
These are bamboo trees.
My grandfather. Okay.
Oh.
So, I can't see. Whatever I have planted, this is for the new generation.
Yes.
Whatever I have already enjoyed, that was planted by somebody
yes.
else. So I never asked
this
question.
You are very kind-hearted. That should be...
I never asked this question, who planted this thing?
Yes, yes.
Look at that.
And how energy came from you?
What to do?
Yes. We have to struggle.
That's what we have to do.
This is unbelievable.
And that was the tree that Nandera. Nandera is the name of the tree.
Which?
It is in fact, it is in Solapur district. Somebody told me that is grown. Nandera tree or something. Nandera or Nandura something.
Do you suggest some trees which are useful?
That's what I am telling you. That one, then Raktachandan, then...
What Raktachandan does?
That is absorbing heat.
Absorbing heat, yes.
Look at that. This is a barren piece of land. There was a huge... At hillock here. Can you imagine? Yala chota parvat mantar na evada utha tha evada uncha hota. There was a hill here. I got that mountain mood by bulldozer and all. I got calling organized bulldozer.
Alright.
We got that all plains. All the trees. Look at that. These are all the trees we put right up to there.
And see here beautiful birds are coming. Which we don't know also.
See again, somebody has come and put this trash here.
Yes.
How people are there. That's all. We're really fighting with this thing, but I don't care. It's okay. Let them do their job, let me do mine.
We have to fight.
So look at that corner. We have developed all. Earlier, we had dogs and all this. So that corner, we have developed all bougainvillea.
Yes, yes.
But look at that, all these things.
See, we're right here, this area. See up.
Yeah. Look at that. We never saw this kind of.
Wow. We feel so much energetic and fresh.
Especially winter and rainy season, it's a feast to come in this area.
Yes, yes. Sir, my last question is that what is your universal message?
My universal message is that everybody should try to contribute to the society back, what he received from society. Everybody should not be just after achieving or earning and all. But when time comes, yes, earning is important in life, and unless you earn, you are nowhere. But after some time, you should know where to draw up a line. And after that, time comes, you have to give back to society. The kind of solace and satisfaction one gets is phenomenal, and it cannot be compared with anything. For me, it's my, as a meditation for me, when I think of something like this thing on these lines to help people and see, and I always fantasize that how can I do more in this field. So that gives me the sort of courage to do something more. That's what the message I would like to give. Everybody must give it back to the society, what he earned from society.
Thank you, sir. You are very great. It's our pleasure to meet like you, persons like you. Thank you very much.
I would request request everybody to subscribe to his channel Seeking Nature and encourage him so that he is always enthusiastic and keen to do new